Hi there, my name is Keith Harvey. I am a fourth-year honours student at Perth College UHI. This is my documentary for my honours project. I am doing it on how valuable is it to use binaural microphones in archaeoacoustics. This documentary will look into the pros and cons of using binaural microphones and to compare them to previously established techniques in the industry. The main section of this documentary will follow my trip around the UK, where I visited over 50 cathedrals using the binaural microphones to gather audio, to showcase the quality of audio, and also to allow the listeners to hear what they would have heard if they'd been there in person. I will then go on to explain why this is such an important aspect for archaeoacoustics. This audio will include clips of organs playing, people singing in the buildings, myself using Nick Green's Gorilla Impulse, as well as clapping in the buildings to get different ranges of acoustics. It will also include ambient sounds from when I was walking around the buildings. However, this will not be the main focus, but it does do a good job of showcasing how well this technique gathers the acoustic feel of the rooms. The first test for using this new technique was at Arbroath Abbey. It is a brilliant building for this because of the sacristy that is there. The sacristy is a beautiful building that has amazing acoustics, and it is a great place to experiment with such a new tech because, one, it was very close to where I am locally, and two, I have two friends that are very good singers, and they were both happy to go in there and improvise, singing different songs and getting a complete different range of vocals. And it was a great experience for testing this technique, as it allowed to have the balloon pops, clapping, we got great spectrogram waves from it, and we also get to see how the binaural microphones work when the researcher, myself, was carrying a camera and filming the entire thing, so we can get a very real sense of what it's like to be there in person with this already stereoed sound that is as it is recorded as it was there in the room. Plymouth Cathedral was pretty much empty except for two staff members for most of the time I was there. When upon arriving, I took some establishing photos and did a quick walk around off the cathedral to get a general feel for the building. I then approached the staff members and asked them if they would be okay with me performing Nick Green's Gorilla Impulse. They were both absolutely fine with me carrying this test out, and here's the recording from that. Firstly, from the binaural microphones. And now from my Tascam handheld recorder. As you can hear, the binaural microphones peaked when the balloon went off due to being so close to the source, and also due to being turned down lower with the input gain, they did not get as much of the room reverb, whereas the Tascam, being further away from the source, did manage to capture a much more rounded sound off the room. This was a noticeable problem with the binaural microphones at the start, in that if you were too close to the source of the sound, they would struggle to cope with the initial loud sound and then the quieter reverbs of the room. However, Plymouth was one of the first cathedrals that I visited on my field trip, and so it was a great time to learn this lesson and allow me to adapt the technique as I went forward. Truro Cathedral was carried out on the same day as Plymouth Cathedral, and once again the staff were very accommodating and allowed me to do a balloon pop in the building, and I actually got invited to come back after they had closed so that I would have complete silence to carry this test out. Once again, first here is it with the binaural microphones. And now with the audio from the Tascam. Once again, you can hear the same problem that happened in Plymouth was the binaural microphones are just too close to the source and cannot capture the reverberation. Newport Cathedral was one of the smallest cathedrals that I visited on my trip, and although small, it still had brilliant acoustics, and I was very lucky that when I was there, the organist was practicing and they gave me permission to record them. And this is where the binaural microphones really come into their own, in that we get a proper real sense of what sound reacts like when a person is standing there and the microphones are recording. Land of Cathedral was a brilliant example of how much the buildings have changed, and this is one of the biggest problems in archaeoacoustics, is trying to understand how people would have perceived buildings that have completely changed. Land of Cathedral was mostly destroyed in World War II, with much work having to be done to replace the different sections of the cathedral. By this point in the field trip, it had become pretty clear that binaural microphones were not brilliant for using the Gorilla Impulse, but I still wanted to do it in cathedrals that were quiet just so I had extra data. And it allowed a good comparison for the problems with this technique and where future improvements could be made. So we have the balloon pop with the binaural microphones. And now from the Tascam. York Cathedral is a massive cathedral, one of the biggest in England, and it is a very big tourist attraction. Knowing this knowledge beforehand, I knew there wouldn't be much chance of doing proper experiments here, but it proved to be brilliant, and it was so busy that you got this great sense of the ambient sounds from being this building being full, and allows us to gather a very accurate representation of the building with so many people in it and getting the ambient sounds that they create in such a space. Coventry Cathedral was one of the most unique on my field trip, as not only was it probably the newest that I was in, but also because it's right next to the old cathedral that was destroyed during World War II. This allows a great example to see how modern architecture is now using acoustics in these buildings compared to the old one. And although the old one is open to the elements now, that doesn't have a roof or windows, it was still quite educational to wander around it with the binaural microphones in to allow us to see some comparisons, as you will now hear. Firstly, inside the new cathedral. And now the old one. The comparison between the two is quite interesting in that they have similar acoustics in that they both still have this large reverb, whereas you would expect the old one at least to be lacking in this now, and the new one is such a different shape from all the other cathedrals that I've been in and that you can see in all the photos throughout this documentary, that it's quite interesting for them to still share these core similarities in their acoustics. Southwell Cathedral offered an excellent opportunity whilst on this field trip, as it showcased the two different styles of architecture that I mainly came across, Romanesque and Gothic, the western half being Romanesque and the eastern half being Gothic, showcasing the two different styles with the new and the old and where they met at the choir. This offered an amazing opportunity for wandering around the cathedral and getting a full audio sweep of the different architecture styles. Similar to York Cathedral, Southwell Cathedral is brilliant because it shows the main benefit of binaural microphone technique, which is to get a feel for the buildings whilst being able to move around rather than having to set up a speaker and microphone system in one place and then move to get different variations of the audio and to get different locations. Binaural microphones allows you to walk around the building and then be able to analyse the whole building in one go very easily and to get the sense of being in the room. Sheffield Cathedral was a very interesting cathedral in that it has been extended in numerous ways and has had to adapt to being in the city centre. This has meant that the structure is now more of an L shape rather than the traditional west to east in a straight line. This offered a very interesting opportunity with the binaural microphones for walking around a cathedral that was not the standard shape, and was even more brilliant in that the organist was playing when I was in there. This gave a brilliant view of how the sound reacts in a different space from what the traditional cathedrals were like. The project at Rosalind Chapel was carried out after my field trip. It was the last stop on it, in fact. And it's a beautiful example of an ancient building that has been converted into something that it might not have once been. Talking to the people who ran it, they seem to think that it was maybe once meant to be a cathedral. And the structure outside of it definitely implies this. As you can see, the outer bit is part of a wall that has never been finished. Roslyn Chapel is also unique because it has a very interesting vaulted ceiling. It has small carvings that all come out about an inch from the walls and the ceilings, and these are amazing for acoustics as they just let the sound reverberate throughout the entire building, and it just gives it this beautiful acoustic. I met Nick Green here and we decided to do both our techniques here using the Gorilla Impulse, the sine wave from the speaker and recorded by the microphone, as well as binaural microphones to be able to compare them both with results. We started in the main section of the chapel to try out the different acoustics in the main section with all the pillars and the beautiful vaulted ceiling before heading down into the crypt. The crypt was stunning for acoustics and we spent a good half hour to an hour down there just making noises. We improvised with our voices and it was a great experience to just try out with different techniques, and we got a great recording with the binaural microphones of myself wearing them and me and Nick harmonizing each other with our voices, and it was a great way to see how binaural microphones react when they are on the source of the sound. The equipment used for this technique by myself on the field trip and at Roslyn Chapel and at Arbroath Abbey, very simple setup. As I mentioned earlier, it is just a handy recorder H2 Zoom, and that is just got the Roland binaural microphones connected into it. You have your windscreens for going over them, and that's it. That's all you require to do this technique and gather information. Come home after your day of research, plug it into your computer and you can analyze it in whatever DAW software you prefer and think is best for this kind of work. I personally really like Logic as I find it quite easy to operate, and I find the EQ and analyzer in it brilliant for seeing which frequencies are most present in buildings. The only other piece of equipment I was using on my trips was a Tascam DR40, which is just another handheld recorder, and that was used simply because, as I found within a couple of cathedrals, this one could not gather the Gorilla Impulse technique in popping balloons. So it was always best to have a backup plan. And the Tascam is another lightweight, just size of slightly bigger than a mobile, but just one-handed device that you can just record with, and it's very easy to use. The only other things that you need for this technique are your computer and a software. The pros of using the binaural microphone technique are that it is very mobile, it's very light and easy to carry, and it is very easy to use. Simple, just standard handheld recorder. I've been using the Zoom handy recorder H2 combined with the Roland CS10EM binaural microphones. It's a very cheap setup and it's brilliant in that it's just so simple to use. It's also excellent for gathering the audio, as we mentioned, in areas where there's a lot of other people. It also comes with some little windscreens to protect the microphones if you're going outside or anywhere that's quite windy. And it has proved very effective in gathering ambient sounds as well as gathering organs when they're playing and being very mobile. This is great for allowing the researcher to get a lot of different areas in the location, such as walking around the entire cathedral, whereas with a normal setup you would have to choose where you wanted to be and move every time you wanted to record, whereas this you just walk and record at the same time, getting a very open view of the room and a very full view of the room. Another benefit of this technique is that it allows different locations that would not have been accessible with the larger volume of equipment that you need for other techniques. This one allows you to get in there. If you have to crawl into a cave, if you've got to climb up some ladders or some old ancient steps, this technique is very versatile. It's just on you. It could be in a pocket. You don't need to carry much with you. It allows for much more condensed research pack of equipment when you are going to different areas, and it's a great technique to use for first analysis of a location. If you think this location is of great value and of great importance, then bring back with more equipment, but this one is a great first analysis of the location. The cons of using this technique are that the main investment in binaural microphones at the moment is focusing on the ones that come in ahead. They have made a model of a human head, and there's two microphones in the ears, and this is a lot more expensive, but also not as useful for what this technique is trying to achieve, in that it's focusing more on putting the whole human body in, whereas this is just a head. Due to this difference of investment, there is not a huge selection of your binaural microphones, with the Roland ones being one of the cheapest. This means that hopefully if more people became interested in this technique, especially in archaeoacoustics, and as this industry grows and people wish to use this technique, hopefully further investment would be put into this technology and therefore increase the accuracy of it. Another con with this one is the inability to use a simple test such as the gorilla impulse with a balloon. This is due to, if you're by yourself anyway, you can't really pop this too close, or else you have to have the input on the microphones down so low that it doesn't really pick up the ambient sounds from the room. And if you have it too loud to try and get those sounds, you peak the microphones when this goes off right next to your head. This means that you do still need two people there. It makes it less attractive when you can't do certain tests like that. However, if you carry around another mobile device that can emit frequencies, if you have just a mobile device nowadays can do this, you can emit a sine wave, or you have a pre-recorded bang and you can play it on a slight delay, then it is not a problem. You just have to adapt to the different situations. The main point and benefit for this technique, however, is to put the human body into the areas and to listen to the room as our ancestors would have, and as other people from history would have interacted with these spaces. It is exceptionally good for allowing us to hear and listen back to what they would have heard due to the human body's effect on sounds in locations. The empty room is not the same as when there is a person in it, and this technique is even better for when the room is full of people. You don't need to worry about trying to set up equipment and people stepping on your cables, having to close off an area so that you can get your equipment set up. You just walk amongst the crowd with this one and you can record different things. It's brilliant for when, if you're in a cathedral and the organ's playing, you can walk and record the organ whilst there's other people there. And then you're getting a much more accurate version of what the sound would have sounded like, in that it is now interacting with all of these other people and yourself, and these microphones can capture all of this. Whereas it's a lot more difficult to get those results with stationary equipment. Thank you very much for watching this documentary, and if you found it interesting, I'm happy that it's helped you. And if you have any tips or tricks or any other ideas that you think are beneficial, please let me know. I'd be thrilled to keep developing this technique, that is my plan. And I really hope that you've enjoyed this, and see you later.